Rhyme and renewal. The Deadly Nannas, or Ngarrindjeri Mulfa, as they're known in Ngarrindjeri, are sharing their language through song and dance.
It's not only about the singing, it's about coming together, it's about translating our songs, writing them and translating them into Ngarrindjeri language. That's really powerful and it's empowering as well. Yeah.
As kids, many of the women heard family speaking Ngarrindjeri, but they weren't allowed to learn it due to assimilation policies and suppression of language by authorities at the time. So now they're teaching themselves.
It empowers me because our language was taken away from us. And, you know, that's a lot of our grief, you know, not knowing our culture and our heritage and especially our language. And now that it's reviving, it gives me strength. It, you know, it helps my miwi, which is my inner spirit.
The Deadly Nannas write their own songs with a mixture of English and Ngarrindjeri to re-educate Aboriginal communities around SA.
So it's really important for us to see that health for Aboriginal people is not just the absence of illness. It's about connection to language, to country, to culture, and that's very lacking.
They're also teaching younger generations in schools and kindergartens.
To be able to have a revival of the Ngarrindjeri language and connect it to children's spaces here is absolutely critical as they formulate their identity within a community.
A good opportunity for them to embrace their own culture sort of thing and learn, obviously, how to sing in our language.
And it's a hit with the students.
Deadly Nannas is very fun.
They danced.
It's in Tui. They weren't singing in the same language.
My wish for the country is that whatever country that you're on, learn that language.
A wish the group hopes will strike a chord with educators.
The beach is calling, Ngarrindjeri.
Brittany Evans for ABC News on Ngarrindjeri Country.